Hello, hello, Ugandans. My name is Dennis Monday. The YouTube channel is Dennis Monday Uganda. Please subscribe to the channel so that you can watch all the videos, educational videos, physics, math, sciences, basically, that I'll be uploading here to help students learn. Subscribe to the channel so that you do not miss any of the videos that I'll upload very soon. So this time I'm coming with a topic of pressure. Pressure, it is a topic in physics for all level, and this goes to the senior 2 students. Senior 2, even those in senior 3 or senior 4, feel free to revise with us. And this is the very first lesson entitled Introduction to Pressure. I want us to dive straight into the lesson, but please subscribe now. Thank you very much. Welcome to the very first video of this topic of pressure and mechanics for all level physics. We have a few questions here to answer in this short video. Question number 1 says, what is pressure? So we define pressure as the force acting normally per unit area, but it's also very important for us to define what the unit area is, because someone may wonder, is the unit area as 1 centimeter squared? Is it 1 meter squared? So we can simply say that pressure is the force acting normally on an area of 1 meter squared. So I'm saying pressure. An area of 1 meter squared. 1 meter squared. Full stop. In other words, we are saying that pressure, if you want to get pressure, you get the force which must be acting normally on an area of 1 meter squared. So pressure is given by the formula F over A. Please note that this area here is called the area of contact. This is called the area of contact. That is the area of contact. Not cross-sectional area. Not surface area, but the area of contact. That's what we mean by this A. It is the area of contact. And the force, you know very well that it is in newtons, and the area has to be in meters squared. Also remember that there is another physical quantity which has the same expression. It is called stress. So stress, similarly, we have what we call stress. Don't confuse the two. Stress is also force over area. I won't give the definition of the stress now, but understand that stress, for stress down here, this is not the area of contact. This is the cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area for stress. And tensile stress is always defined as the ratio of the tensile force to the cross-sectional area of a material and the mechanical properties of matter. So we define pressure in simple terms as the force acting normally on an area of 1 meter squared. Pressure is the force acting normally on an area of 1 meter squared. And also, you should know that the word normally, when we say it is acting normally, we're not saying it is acting usually, as some people say. Normally, what we mean by acting normally, it means that it is acting perpendicularly. It is acting perpendicularly. So you are free to say that pressure is the force acting perpendicularly on an area of 1 meter squared. In other words, if this is the surface that we are talking about, the force should be acting normally. You know, it should be acting normally. If this is the force, it should be acting perpendicularly. Exactly. So that's our first thing. Question answered. Pressure is the force acting normally on an area of 1 meter squared. Question number 2. State the SI unit of pressure. State the SI unit of pressure. Let me zoom out a little. Okay. So, state the SI unit of pressure. Now, from what we've just written, from the formula we've just written down, we said that pressure is given by force over the area, and the area is the area of contact. So what is the SI unit of force? You all know very well that the SI unit of force, this force is in newtons. Force is in newtons. And the area of contact being an area, the SI unit is a square meter. So that means that when you divide by the law of indices, you realize that the meters squared are in the denominator. That means that we shall have newtons per square meter. Newtons per square meter. So the SI unit of pressure is basically, you can say, newtons per square meter. Newtons per square meter. And if you don't want to say newtons per square meter, then you can use you can simply say that pressure also has another unit which we call the pascal. So we either have newtons per square meter, or so we take this, and I always advise students always use symbols. They're always very easy for you not to mess up. If you can quote properly, in some books you find they say newtons per square meter. We encourage the index form. The first one here is the one that we encourage, where what is in the denominator is given in negative power, like that. So newtons per square meter or pascal. I said the SI unit. So the SI unit of pressure is the pascal. Plural, you write pascals. And abbreviated as capital P small a pascal. Yeah, pascal. So that's how we handle pressure. Pressure, by definition, is a force acting normally on an area of 1 meter squared, and the SI unit of pressure is the pascal. Is the pascal. Write the word only. If I ask you to write the SI unit of pressure, please don't state the word and again the symbol. Just choose one. Like a question comes. Imagine a question comes and they say, what is the SI unit of pressure? So a student should just say, capital P, small a. That's enough. You get your mark. Or someone else says, no, I don't want the PA. I'm going to write NM power negative 2. And that's right. Very simple. NM power negative 2. That is the newtons. Those are the newtons per square meter. Okay, finally, if you're doing calculations in pressure, then just always remember that if, for example, question 3, question 3 says, so we have a box of mass 30 kilograms resting on a surface of 0.6 meters squared, and they want us to calculate the pressure that is exerted on that surface. Imagine such a question. Very easy to handle. So, but you'll be surprised that when some students are faced with such a question, they fail to realize that they have been given the mass, and they use it directly. Now, we said that if you want to get pressure, you simply say pressure is equal to the force over the area of contact. Now, the area of contact here is the surface of the box, which is on the ground. So that is the 0.6 meters squared. But our challenge is, what is the force? The force that the box exerts on the surface is going to be its weight. So in other words, we have to identify that the force is going to be the weight of the body of the box. And you know very well that the weight is given by mg. So get the mass times acceleration due to gravity. We are going to get this mass here and convert it into the weight. Change it into a weight. And remember, in O-level, our acceleration due to gravity is just 10. So in other words, you're going to have the given 30 times 10, implying that you're going to end up with 300 newtons. 300 newtons. So that is our force. So therefore, we'll have that the pressure, which is required, pressure is going to be force over the area. We already wrote the formula, we don't need to repeat. The force we have obtained is 300 newtons divided by our area is 0.6 meters squared. And if you divide comfortably here, you're going to end up with 500. So we end up with 500 pascals. That's it. So you get your marks. You are free to write 500 newtons per square meter. Yeah. Another person may say, 500 newtons per square meter. Like that. Okay. Please let's meet now in lesson number 2 about pressure. Thank you very much.